It's one of the seven wonders of the world. Yet the Great Pyramid of Giza has never yielded all its secrets. No major new structure has been discovered since the Middle Ages. Nobody's ever fathomed how it was built 4,500 years ago. But in November 2017, the Scan Pyramids team published their findings in Nature magazine. They announced a new major discovery at the very heart of the pyramid. They detected above the Grand Gallery a previously unknown cavity at least 30 meters long. They named it SPBV, Scan Pyramids Big Void. It's the second important discovery the researchers have made after the announcement in October 2016 of a corridor situated behind the gigantic chevrons of the north face. The level of confidence of these discoveries is more than 5 sigma. In other words, it's 1 in 3.5 million that these findings are by chance. Designed and directed by Cairo University and the HIP Institute, the Scan Pyramid's mission began in October 2015. Its aim is to use non-invasive methods to scan the pyramid and detect unknown internal structures in order to better understand the Old Kingdom pyramids. The Scan Pyramids team of French, Japanese, and Egyptian scientists used a penetrating radiography technique called muography. The Earth and everything on it, including the Great Pyramid, is permanently bombarded by minuscule, invisible particles, muons, byproducts of cosmic rays only partially absorbed by stone. The more these elementary particles from space hit matter on the journey, the more they're stopped in their tracks. The idea is to place inside the structure devices to count the number of muons that cross through it and work out their distribution angle. It's rather like an X-ray on a human being. Muography will help detect the differences in density inside the pyramid and provide an internal image of the monument. 3 different techniques of muography were used, each independent of the other, and each was corroborated by in-depth computer simulations. First, Nagoya University used plates containing a chemical film sensitive to muons. Then another Japanese team from the KEK Institute transported piece by minute piece and then reassembled a very sophisticated device inside the Queen's Chamber. It was a scintillator, an electronic instrument that uses different technology to detect the muons. Finally, at the foot of the north face, a third team installed equipment outside the pyramid. This was the French team from the CEA. They were working with yet another different muographic method, telescopes fitted with gas detectors. In 2016, Nagoya University's compact devices revealed the existence of the cavity situated behind the chevrons of the north face, but without being able to determine its architectural shape. In 2017, 2018, and 2019, new plates were hung along the descending corridor and also in the niches of the Al Mamun Tunnel. All the experiments reconfirmed the existence of the cavity that they named the Scan Pyramid's North Face Corridor, between 17 and 23 meters above ground level. A corridor at least 5 meters long. The corridor is horizontal, or perhaps sloping upwards, and the theory of a corridor going down and parallel to the descending corridor has been ruled out. But that's not all. The scientists from the Scan Pyramids mission also made progress on understanding the Scan Pyramids' big void, refining their data analysis. Since the publication 2 years ago in Nature magazine, they continue their research and gather millions of new data to look at it from new points of view inside the Great Pyramid. The CEA had set up new equipment in the Grand Gallery with several angles to observe the big void above this space, and Nagoya University also placed emulsion plates at several points along the Grand Gallery. Then other plates were installed at the entrance to the King's Chamber and above it in the relieving chambers. The big void was again observed from these new measuring points, confirming and refining the results published in 2017. The cavity is just above the Grand Gallery, between 10 and 15 meters above. Its minimum length, estimated initially at 30 meters, has been re-evaluated to 40 meters minimum, probably in one single section. However, the mission scientists continue to debate about a slope. And there's more. The plates placed above the King's Chamber detected no anomaly between the arches above and the summit of the pyramid. Finally, during the summer of 2018, the team moved the KEK scintillator into the unfinished underground chamber, and the Nagoya emulsion plates were positioned in several places. This muon data capture is still ongoing. In 2020, the Scan Pyramids project will carry on to gather more data from the very heart of the Great Pyramid. Once again, emulsion plates will be installed and the CEA's muon telescopes will be placed in the descending passage to understand more about how the discovered North Face corridor located above extends behind the chevrons of the North Face. Enough to motivate the scientists to think about minimally invasive methods to explore this corridor, which could prove key to understanding how the Egyptians built the Great Pyramid.